And all the one lower lad that throws a word away. I'm surprised myself at times at all I've got to say.
Roman in the clothing of the body bags of supplies. Roman in the clothing with my sweetie by my side. And the sun has gone to rest, that's the time that
Chairman greets you. You reply vociferously with a good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. Now, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman.
See how simple it is when you have a little bit of rehearsal? And welcome to the Freer Gallery's production of the British Players 50th Anniversary Music Hall. Well, part of it. You didn't pay enough money to get the whole show. Well, we will present an ambitious array of abundantly accomplished artists, acquired to arouse an ambrosia and abandonment, accentuating an aberration of audience adulation, amusement, amazement, all affirmable accolades of illusion. Ooh. Try and do that with a couple of gin and tonics. So we must have a lot of visitors in town. How many visitors? Who's from out of town? Put your hands up. From where are you from? Where are you from?
Nashville, Tennessee.
Nashville, Tennessee. Where else? What? All over there. Well, you don't get out much, do you? Where else?
Massachusetts.
Good. Lovely place.
Seattle, Washington.
Oh, love Seattle. Love that fish market where they chuck the fish to each other. It's fantastic. Anybody from England? I didn't mention the World Cup, but I think you could have made a bigger cheer than that, all right? Yes? England?
Yes.
Whereabouts?
Wallington.
Wallington?
In the north.
I know, far from Durham.
I know, I can tell you from the north.
No. And I left there about 50 years ago. Just right, we're going to have fun, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
Well, let's give them a rousing send-off. Jug, let's take the show up. Well, my first pleasurable event is, of course, to introduce the Palace of Variety Orchestra. On the double bass, we have Mr. Fred Talcott. Our assistant director is Mr. Peter Narrowstone. And our accompanist is a very talented man who writes a lot of material for a group called Hexagon that does a political satire in Washington once a year, is Mr. Douglas Mauer. So the rest of you is all from Washington, D.C., are you? Mm-hmm. Or the area?
Yeah.
Yeah? Do you go and see Hexagon?
Yeah.
Good. Do you go and see the British Players? Bad. Oh, I'm going to tell some really bad jokes now. But I was asked to do something to warm you up and make you all feel part of the show. So in order to do that, I'm going to tell you a little story, and you're all going to have to join in. It's about three little ducks called Quack, 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 and...
quack, quack, quack.
Oh, they were much quicker in West Virginia last week. Three little ducks called...
quack, 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 quack.
And...
quack, quack, quack.
One day...
quack, quack, quack.
Said to...
quack, quack.
I think we should take...
quack.
Out for his birthday dinner. To which...
quack, quack.
Said to...
quack, quack.
What a terrific idea. So they went out for dinner, having a wonderful time, and
quack,
said to,
quack,
and
quack, quack.
This is fantastic. I'm having a wonderful time. The food's terrific. Well, they went home, and during the night,
quack,
took ill. Ah. So you come and see the players, you get used to this. So during the night,
quack,
took ill.
Ah.
So they called in the doctor. Doctor examined, he says, nothing wrong with him, just a bit of wind, and off he went. During the night,
quack,
died.
Oh.
To which,
quack, quack,
said to,
quack, quack, quack.
I think that doctor was a...
quack.
Well, there you are. Now you're all embedded in the show. It's like that, that's the best of the jokes, so enjoy it. Ladies and gentlemen, to open our show is a hugely talented man. He is, of course, the cheeky chap himself, Mr. Albert Coya. When I was just a little lad, I would get up with me dad as the two of us prepared to face the day. While I struggled with me shirt until me fingers hurt, in his underwear he'd while the time away. When the moment came to leave, he'd take a shirt without a sleeve, or back or tail, just collar, front and tie. As through the door he sped, he would pull it o'er his head. 'Twas all in just a twinkling of an eye. Now poor dad has passed away, and although it's sad to say, in departing he has filled my heart's desire. Because I chanced to find, in the things he left behind, this most ingenious item of attire. Yes, now I've got a little dicky, a lovely little dicky. It's the finest little dicky in the land. Wherever I may go, it's comforting to know my dicky's always close at hand. A dicky's always ready, be it work or play or beddy by, or possibly an evening on the town. Yes, no matter the endeavour, there is not to fear whatever, for a dicky never, never lets you down. My wedding night in a cottage down in Brighton, the wife and I had supper all alone. We dined on escargot and a possible Bordeaux and some lamb chops that we nibbled to the bone. As the candles flickered down, it was then I went to town, breathing words of tender passion in her ear. Don't know just what I said, but from the way her face turned red, I assumed my aspirations were quite clear. Not another word was said as we toddled off to bed, with my eager heart just bursting into flame. I had barely shut the door, dropped me coat upon the floor, when suddenly I heard my wife exclaim, I say, you've got a little dicky, a darling little dicky. Why, there's no one with a dicky quite like you. You really must be proud to stand out in a crowd. I wish I had a dicky too.
I said I'll let you use it if you're sure you won't abuse it, for I fear it's in a state of slow decline. She said I'd really love to, but it seems a trifle small. I said it only looks that way because I'm rather tall. Besides, you should be happy that you're getting it at all. For it's such a lovely dicky, a darling little dicky, a smashing little dicky, and it's mine, all mine. A lovely little dicky, and it's mine.
In the mail that said, you can have sex at 85. She thought, well, I live at 63. That's not far to walk. And we talk among themselves to get these jokes, don't worry. And now that vital, vivacious, and voluptuous vocalist, Miss Terry Aldrin.
Sing it through again, and then we'll all chime in. It'll make your heart feel light. You'll You'll be hoarse tomorrow, but forget your sorrow while we bust a core tonight.
Bust a core tonight if you're a low-down bass. Come on and take my place.
And the tenor will be bum, bum, bum.
If you're a baritone, don't sit around alone.
And a lead is what we need right over there. Over there.
Over where?
Over there.
Over there.
Send the lead, send the lead over there.
Over there.
Let's bust a chord or two, and then you'll know it's true that a song makes things go right. Put away your trouble, let your joy be double while we bust a chord tonight. While we bust a chord tonight.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, that wickedly witty and winsome Miss Jennifer Strand.
They came from far and wide, and when the people saw the marrow, everybody cried, "Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh, what a beauty! It must be 2 feet long or even more. It's such a lovely color, so nice and round and fat. I never thought a marrow could grow as big. I've never seen one as big as that before. He was leaning on the garden gate the other day and beckoned to a lady who lives just across the way. Took her down the garden path and showed it her with pride. And when she saw the size of it, the little lady sighed. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh, what a beauty! It must be 2 feet long or even more. It's such a lovely color, so nice and round and fat. I never thought a marrow could grow as big as that. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. The show was held and everybody went to see the great big marrow lying there inside the tent. Soon the judges came around to give the prizes out. They only took one look at it and then began to shout. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh, what a beauty! Even more. It's such a lovely color, so nice and round and fat. I never thought a marrow could grow as big as that. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh no! I've never seen one as big as that before.
Young lady goes to confessions, goes into confessions, says down, says, "Father, forgive me for how I've sinned." Priest said, "Confess your sins and be forgiven." She says, "Last night my boyfriend and I made mad, passionate love 7 times. The priest thought long and hard and said, "Go home, squeeze the juice of 7 lemons into a glass and drink it." She said, "Will Father, will that cleanse me of my sins?" He said, "No, but it will wipe that silly smile off your face." And now the man. man who has been described as one of the country's rising young stars, and here is the man who said it, Mr. Bill Carucas.
Hello, everyone. Good to see you. So great to see you. I have had a bit of bad luck lately, let me tell you. Now, my old Aunt Rebecca is rich. She's the Dowager Duchess of Diddle. When she dies, I inherit a million or so, but the old girl's as fit as a fiddle. Whilst gunning the moors on the 12th, in a quiet, lonely spot by the sea, I saw someone there, by the cliff I declare, 'twas the Dowager Duchess of Dee. At that critical moment, some birds came in sight. So I upped with my gun and I blazed left and right. And I nearly hit Auntie, yes, nearly, not quite. And bang, with the chance of a lifetime. Now, I once wooed a sweet, winsome wench. She was 19 and also an heiress. Now, it's nice when a girl is a Venus galore and also a millionairess. I wooed her, I wooed her, I won. My darling, she said, I am thine. She swore to be true, so I thought I would too. What do you think? I thought it was fine. Ah, sweet hyacinth, fairest of flowers that blow, and a millionaire pa in Chicago, what ho? So we put up the bands, then my wife got to know, and bang, with the chance of a lifetime. And her mother last June went to visit the Marquis de Caxy. Our family carriage was under repair, so I saw them safe off in a taxi. Bye-bye, darlings. Then somewhere about 10 o'clock came a telegram, heavens alive. Poor dear Ma and the wife, fearful crash, loss of life, total wreck of the 845. It was a terrible crash, 80 passengers slain, and I manfully struggled my tears to restrain. When the ghastly news reached me, they both missed the train, and bang, with the chance of a lifetime. I mean, really, Nicky, well, I'm so dull.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the management, at enormous expense, has spanned the Atlantic to bring you the last of the Red Hot Mamas. Please, gentlemen, give a rousing reception for Miss Bethany Blakey.
Two sweethearts courted happily for quite a while. This simple life of country folk. When the lad told girly he must go away, a little heart with grief most broke. She said, you know it's true, I love you best of all, so honey, don't you go away. Just as he went to go, it grieved the girlie so. These words he heard her say. Some of these days you'll miss me, honey. Some of these days you'll feel so. Honey, when you go away, to and show him two can play this game. When honey heard this melancholy news, he quickly came back home again. But when he reached the house, he found his girl was gone. So down he rushes to the train. As it was pulling out, he heard his girly shout this loving, sweet refrain. Some of these days you'll miss me, honey. Some of these days you'll feel so lonely. You'll miss my hugging, you'll miss my kissing, you'll miss me, honey. When you go away, you'll feel so lonely. Just
has pheasant plucking sessions with the vicar of a Sunday twixt the first and second lessons. I'm not the pheasant plucker, I'm the pheasant plucker's mum. I'm only plucking pheasants till the pheasant pluckers come. I'm not the pheasant plucker, I'm the pheasant plucker's mum. He's only plucking pheasants till the pheasant pluckers come.
Most adept, he's really got the knack.
He likes to have a pheasant plucked before he hits the sack. I like to lend a helping hand, I gather up the feathers. It's really all our pheasant plucking keeps us pair together. I'm not the pheasant plucker, I'm the pheasant plucker's friend. I'm only plucking pheasants as a means unto an end.
Woo! I'm not the pheasant plucker, I'm the pheasant plucker's friend. I'm only plucking pheasants as a means unto an end.
Me husband's in the forest, always banging with his gun. If he could hear me heartfelt cries, I'm sure that he would come. For there's fluff in all me crannies, and there's feathers up me nose. And I'm itching in the kitchen, from me head down to me toes. I'm not the pheasant plucker, I'm the pheasant plucker's wife. And when we pluck together, it's a pheasant plucking life.
I'm not the pheasant plucker, he's the pheasant plucker's wife. When they plot together, it's a pheasant plucking life.
Some of you may know that with different words. And now our next performers need no introduction, as they have already met. Welcome, if you will, Dyer, Kaplan, Angelucci, Wilson, and Strand.
If I were not upon the stage, something else I'd rather be. If I were not upon the stage, a swimmer would suit me. You'd hear me all day long, and this would be my song. Overarm breaststroke, dive into the sea. Overarm breaststroke, dive into the sea. If I were not upon the stage, something else I'd rather be. If I were not upon the stage, a tennis player would suit me. You'd hear me all day long, and this would be my song. Swing your racket, bash your ball straight across the net. Swing your racket, bash your ball straight across the net. Swing your racket, bash your ball straight across the net. Swing your racket, bash your ball straight across the net. If I were not upon the stage, something else I'd rather be. If I were not upon the stage, a gym mistress would suit me. You'd hear me all day long, and this would be my song. Touch your toes, take a deep breath, tuck down to your knees. Touch your toes, take a deep breath, tuck down to your knees. Overhaul is dash your roll, straight across the net. Overhaul is dash your roll, straight across the net.
Don't forget the bush.
Swing your racket, bash your
gentlemen, that elegant, if gregarious entertainer, Mr. Sean Perry.
Come on!
artistes, not two artistes, but three artistes. Please welcome the titulating trio of Kaplan, Aldred, and Sinks.
Like up in town,
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West.
My story was written by Shakespeare sublime.
My bareback performance is famous in rhyme.
And everyone's been up to see me sometime.
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West. Of the best.
Mark Anthony thought I was rather a find.
I've got Peeping Tom at the back of my mind.
And everyone's been up to see me sometime.
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West.
A word of advice to the men, here we go.
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West.
You're looking for nice bits of home.
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West.
We're three bits of pastry who like to be sussed. So give us a ring if it comes to the...
Worst.
And don't forget me if you want a good bust.
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West.
Cleopatra, Diva, Mae West. Of the best.
They made me a mummy all pickled in salt.
I shocked all the mummies when I made a halt.
If I'm not a mummy, it isn't my fault.
Cleopatra,
Diva,
Mae West.
Cleopatra, Diva, Mae West. In history's pages, we're three of the best.
I bathed in the Nile and they all said, what ho!
I gave Peeping Tom a good eyeful, I know.
I bathe all alone, but it's not a bad show.
Cleopatra, Diva, Mae West.
The man of whom the Queen of England once said, who's he? He is, of course, Mr. Danny Grogan.
Good afternoon, ladies. And there's me calling you ladies and gentlemen. You all, of course, know what you are. You look wonderful, you look marvellous, you look intelligent, you look so well-dressed, you look fantastic. I also lie a lot. You may laugh if you like. No, seriously, folks, I said to my wife this morning, I said, where would you like to go on your vacation? She said, I'd like to go to somewhere interesting, romantic, and a place that I seldom have always dreamed about, but never have actually gone there. So I took us to the kitchen. Now, I'll tell you, I'm not saying my wife is a poor cook, but we say grace and prayers after the meal. She said to me this morning, she said, you look like the Titanic. I said, of course, majestic, strong, large, virile, amazing. She said, no, an old creaking wreck and lying at the bottom. Last week I was in the bathtub and I had a funny, funny feeling all down my left-hand side. This week, I've had a funny feeling all down my right side. I can't wait for next week. I must admit, folks, I went to a restaurant last night. I went to a restaurant and I walked up to the waiter and I said, waiter, do you have frog's legs? He said, yes, we do. I said, well, good. Hop over the counter and get us two cheese sandwiches, would you? Here, what do you call a gorilla with a banana in each ear? Anything you want, he can't hear you. I must admit, folks, I'll tell you, Moses comes down from Mount Sinai with two tablets, and he addresses the multitude, and he says, I've got some good news, and I've got some bad news. He said, the good news is I've got the big man down to 10. He said, the bad news, adultery is still in. Now, I'll tell you. I've just got back from Ireland, dear old Ireland myself, the place where I was born, dear old Dublin itself. I'll never forget my mother's first words when she saw me for the first time. She said, my goodness me, nurse, has there been a mistake? Now, I'll tell you honestly, seriously, I went up there to the National Space Centre, right over there, I have a friend works there. I walked straight up and there was an astronaut walking out. And I went up to the astronaut and I said to him, where's your next mission to? He said, sir, let me tell you, we're going to the sun. I said, you're going to the sun? You're going to get burnt to a crisp. He said, that's all right, sir, we've figured it out. We're going at night. Now, I tell you, I heard two men arguing on the side of O'Connell Street. I couldn't believe it. And one of them said, you know, Pat, he said, I've just figured out a 20-piece jigsaw puzzle and it's only taken me 1 month. And his Pat said, well, what's the big deal about that? And he said, well, look, let me show you. On the side of the box here, it said, for 4 to 6 years. I tell you, honestly, I'm absolutely amazed. My dear old mother, God bless her in heaven, she went one time in Dublin to buy a vacuum cleaner. And the salesman said to her, he said, madam, this vacuum cleaner will cut your work in half. She said, oh, terrific, fantastic, I'll take two of them. I went to a museum over there in Dublin, very similar to this museum here. And I walked right in the front door, and on the right-hand side was this magnificent Gaelic rock. Beautiful thing. I was astonished. I looked at this marvellous rock, and I was so amazed. I went up to a security guard. I said, excuse me, guard, but could you possibly tell me how old that beautiful Gaelic rock is? He said, let me tell you, sir. That is 6 million years old and 3 months. I was astonished, I was amazed. I said, how can you be so precise? He said, well, look, let me tell you. When I arrived at the museum, I was told that that was 6 million years old. He said, and I've been here 3 months. I tell you, I went on a tour guide. I went all round this beautiful city of Dublin, and there was this big Irish driver, red face, red hair, driving a big bus like this. And I got right behind him. All day long, he was going to one site and saying, on this site in 1625, the British got absolutely hammered on this site. And he'd drive a bit further. And he said, on this site in 1797, the British got slaughtered on this site. All day long. And the British got murdered on this site. And all. At the end of the tour, I couldn't believe it. I walked straight up to the driver and I whispered in his ear, I said, did the British win anything at all? He said, not on this tour bus. My father, my dear old father, God bless him, he said to me one time, he says, what's the difference, son, between an Irish wake and an Irish wedding? I said, I'm sorry, Dad. He said, one less drunk. Now, I'll tell you. I'll never forget my father's final words on this earth. Watch out, a bus! Now, I tell you, he was asked one time where he would like to be buried. He said, surprise me. Little girl is a little girl and she keeps biting on her fingernails. And her mother said, if you keep biting your fingernails, you're going to get fat. She said, if I bite me, she said, yes, if you keep biting your fingernails, you're going to get fat. So as it happens, this little girl and her mother, they get on a bus and they just happen to sit right opposite a pregnant lady. Well, the little girl, she keeps looking at the lady and looking down at her tummy. Looking, you know, couldn't. Finally, the lady stands up, pregnant lady. She says to the little girl, she says, A little girl, do you know me? And the little girl says, no, but I know what you've been doing. Now, I'd say... How can you tell the most popular man at a nudist colony? Well, he's the one who can hold 2 hot coffees and 12 donuts all at the same time. Thank you very much, ladies.
Mr. Brogan's friends laughed when he said he was going to become a comedian. Well, they're not laughing now. And now, a young lady who never fails to disarm, discord, nay, disarm, the lovely Miss Daria Antonucci. Used to go to the state fair every year. And every year, the finest thing at the State Fair was the acrobatic plane rides. And every year, Morris would say, Esther, I want to ride in one of those planes. And every year, Esther would say, Morris, I know, but those airplane rides cost $50. And after all, $50 is $50. But one year they went, and Morris said, Esther, I'm 85 years old. If I don't ride in that airplane soon, I never will. And Esther said, I know, Morris, but those airplane rides cost $50, and $50 is $50. Well, as luck would have it, the pilot was walking behind me. He said, excuse me, I couldn't help it over here, and I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll take you both up in the airplane, I'll do all the stunts, all the tricks, and if you don't make a sound, you can ride for free. But you make one sound, and I'll have to charge you $50. So they agreed, they take off. Well, he goes through his entire repertoire, not a sound. He goes back and does another series of tricks, not a sound. Eventually he lands, and he goes up to Morris and said, I can't believe it, I didn't think anybody could go through that airplane ride and not make a sound. And Morris said, well, I was going to say something when Esther fell out, but $50. Come on, I'm going to do it. Back from India with the 33rd afoot, Major Bill Caruccas.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for coming here.
Yes. When I was in the army, I was a cavalry man, you know. And whenever I went on parade, a magnificent picture I made. With my galloping here and my galloping there, this ridiculous habit I got. And I'm hanged if I don't think I'm galloping now. Whether I'm up in the saddle or not. And the people all stare at me so, for it matters not where I may go. It's a bumpety 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 bump as if I were riding my charger. A bumpety 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 bump as proud as an Indian Raja. All the girls declare that I'm a gay old stager. Hey, hey, clear the way. Here comes the galloping major. I've always been a ladies' man, a favorite with the sex. And I called upon one yesterday, though I won't give the lady away. She started to talk of my army career, which was most interesting, you see. And we stopped for a while and we talked about her, which was more interesting to me. And she said I'd been taking some wine. And before we started to dine, I went a bumpety 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 bump as if I were riding my charger. Bumpety 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 bump, proud as an Indian Raja. All the girls declare that I'm a gay old stager. Hey, hey, clear the way. Here comes the galloping major. Thank you very much. Carry on clapping, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, but gentlemen in particular, please try to remain seated as we welcome back the red hot mama herself, Miss Bethany Blakey.
Just as he was about to try out down to the hardware store. Got another key for my front door. And he's a good man. He's better than you. He starts his loving where you get through. So take my tip, honey, and leave my door. Because your key don't fit this lock no more. You got the right key, you're just putting it in the wrong keyhole.
Crescent. They threw it one brick at a time. Someone threw a fender which caught me a bender. I hoisted my white flag and tried to surrender. They jeered me, they queered me, and half tried to stone me to death. They threw nuts and sultanas, fried eggs and bananas. The night I appeared as Macbeth. The advertised time for the curtain was 6:45 on the sheet. The hall keeper, he, having misplaced the key, we played the first act in the street. Then somebody called for the author. He's dead, said the flute player's wife. The news caused an awful commotion and gave me the shock of my life. Shakespeare dead? Poor old Bill. Why, I never knew the poor fellow was ill. I acted so tragic, the house rose like magic. I gave them such wonderful thrills. My tender emotion caused so much commotion that dress circle made out their wills. The gallery boys straining dropped tears and complaining. The pits put umbrellas up, they thought it was raining. Some boated, some floated, and five of the band met their death. The poor program winning sell programs while swimming. The night I appeared as Macbeth, I acted so tragic, the house looked like magic. The audience yelled, "You're sublime!" They made me a present of Mornington Crescent. They threw it one brick at a time. Someone threw a fender which caught me a bender. I hoisted my white flag and tried to surrender. They jeered me, they queered me, and half tried to stone me to death. They threw nuts and sultanas, fried eggs and bananas. The night I appeared as Macbeth.
That, ladies and gentlemen, brings us to the end of our show and to our grand finale, performed by the entire company.
Thank you. too. We can depend on you. Freedom remains, these are the chains nothing can break.
There'll always be an England, and England shall be free. If England means as much to you as England means to me.
Under the table you must go, E-I-E-I-E-I-O.
You have been the best Saturday afternoon audience we've had
this week!
Thank you.